हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। सो आई थिंक माई प्रीवियस लेक्चर इज़ क्लियर टू यू। सो टूडे वी विल डिस्कस द रेस्ट पार्ट ऑफ द चैप्टर। सो वेलकम टू माई नेक्स्ट लेक्चर, ग्रेड 9, चैप्टर 2, टॉपिक टिश्यू। सो टूडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एनिमल टिश्यू। एज आई टोल्ड यू, देयर आर 4 टाइप ऑफ द एनिमल टिश्यू। फर्स्ट इज द epithelial tissue, second connective tissue, third is the muscular tissue, and fourth is the nervous tissue. So today we will discuss about the epithelial tissue and their types. These are the 4 type of tissue as I told you. Okay, so let's start with epithelial tissue. Characteristic of the epithelial tissue: cells are basically closely packed there. That means no intercellular spaces are there, okay, and that lie on the basement membrane. Okay, so that's the general structure of the epithelia. Now location: epithelial tissue basically found or cover the body and lining that cavity or tubes, that outer and inner lining of most of the body organ, such as GIT, that is gastrointestinal tract, that blood vessels, urinary tract, heart chamber and uterus, that found on entire exposed surface of the body, such as skin, and it is also found in the glands. Now the functions of the epithelial tissue: It plays a role of defense and protect body organ. Second, that secrete gastric juice in the stomach, which help in the digestion. It also absorb digested food in the intestine, that means also help in the absorption of the digested food. Next, that remove waste in the form of sweat from the skin. Okay, after that epithelial tissue is basically of two type: simple epithelium and stratified epithelium. So firstly we will discuss simple epithelium. Simple epithelium, as the name indicate, that is simple tissue, okay, and consists of single layer of the identical cell. Same type of cells are present and found on the absorptive or secretory surfaces like skin. And the simple epithelial tissue is divided into 3 main types: squamous epithelial tissue, which is flattened in the shape, cuboidal tissue, which is cube like and columnar epithelium, that cells are tall. Okay, after that, classification of the epithelium based on the number of the cells layer. There are 2 type of the epithelia: simple epithelia and stratified epithelia. And based on the cell shape, there are 3 type: squamous epithelia, cuboidal epithelia and columnar epithelia. Okay, so let's start about squamous epithelia. We will discuss type of epithelia, structure, location and the function. So first is squamous epithelia. If we are talking about the structure, that cells are thin, flat, irregular, which lies like floor tiles to form a delicate lining known as pavement epithelium, and nucleus is present in the center. Location: esophagus, lining of the mouth, alveoli of the lungs and blood vessels. And the function of squamous epithelia: it protect the underlining tissue from injury of germs, help in exchange of the gases in lungs and material between cells and blood. Now cuboidal epithelia structure: cells are cuboidal in the shape and having round nuclei, which is present in the center. And if you're talking about the location, that present in the kidney tubules and duct of the salivary glands. Function: that provide mechanical support, and at the time of epithelial tissue, that fold and form a gland that secretes substance. Such epithelium is known as glandular epithelium, which help in the secretion. Third is columnar epithelium, that cells are more tall and less wide. Pillar-like structure is there and placed side by side. And nucleus is situated near the base. It is also found in a rectangular shape. Lining, inner lining of intestine, respiratory tract, okay, and present in the form of cilia, also known as ciliated columnar epithelium, help in absorption, excretion and secretion. Now, stratified epithelial tissue, characteristic that consists of several layers of the cell of various shapes. The continuous division of the cell in the lower layer that push that cells above and come nearer to the surface when they are shed. Basement membrane are usually absent, and the main function is to protect underlining structure from mechanical wearing and the tearing. Okay, so rest part we will discuss in the next lecture. Okay, I hope this video will be helpful for you. So till then, stay at home, stay safe, be happy, and thank you.